So I'm a little ashamed, but actually... Hello everybody, it's your girl Jay, and today I am here with a Netgalley what's on my shelf type of video. I saw this on Bookishly Bethany's channel where she ran down basically every single Netgalley book she's read and what she thought of them, yada yada. I'm just going to be doing my TBR shelf because I've been approved for 87 titles and I've given feedback for 70. I feel like going through 87 titles is a lot and I don't want to do that. But if you guys are interested in a what's on my Netgalley shelf of my read books, like I will give you that. So let me know down below if you want to see that. But this is my Netgalley TBR shelf. So without further ado, let us get started. So I currently only have 14 books on my TBR shelf for Netgalley. I have an 80% ratio, which is what it's suggested on Netgalley to have. So I'm just kind of trying to keep that momentum going. So I guess this is kind of like my motivational get that shit done type of video. The first book that I'm currently in the middle of, I'm on like page 135 or something like that, is a middle grade graphic novel. It is called Picasso by Remy Lay. It is the cutest freaking thing ever so far. Like, I am enjoying it so much. It's about a little girl named Jo, and she ends up meeting a dog named Picasso who goes on shopping trips by itself. A group of kids at a local bookstore are participating in an art class, and they mistake Jo for Picasso's owner. Jo ends up going along with the lie of her being the owner because she just wants some friends. When a cranky old man decides that Picasso should not be allowed off the leash because it is the law, the town gets divided on those who are in support of Picasso and those who believe that he should be on a leash. So the children at the art class decide that they're going to start a petition to have Picasso be able to roam free. And as the petition gains more traction and becomes more popular in the town, Jo is worried that the true owners of Picasso will see it and call out her lie and she'll lose all her new friends. And it's like the story of that. But like I said, it is so cute so far. I'm going to finish it fairly soon. I think I'll probably end up giving it a 4 out of 5 stars. Like, I just think it's really cute and I really like the artwork. It's very bright and vibrant. I'm actually being sent a full copy of this book, but it has not arrived yet. It's actually being published on May 25th, so I definitely recommend you guys go out and pick it up or request it at your local library because it is a cute one and I think that everybody should read it because it's just so adorable. Okay, now on to the other books on my shelf. I'm going to start with the oldest books that I've had on my shelf for so long because there are some from like 2018 that I still have not picked up yet. So I'm a little ashamed. I actually have finished copies of them all, so I will get to them eventually. It's just when I get around to it. I actually can show you guys which ones they are because they're right here. The first one that has been on my shelf for 1,000 years has been Here There Be Monsters. This is by a Melinda Berube. Not 100% sure how to say their last name, but this is like a horror YA. It says that it is a story of sisterhood turned toxic, imaginary monsters brought to life, and secrets that won't stay buried. This actually came out in 2019 in August, so we're very behind on it. It follows a 16-year-old girl named Sky who has a little sister named Deidre. Deidre kind of follows her around all the time, and Sky's kind of tired of that, so when they end up moving, she thinks that this is the perfect time to come into herself. She makes some new friends. Deidre, on the other hand, withdraws, and she becomes obsessed with a swamp that is behind their new house. Then one day Deidre goes missing and a monster comes creeping up to her window one night claiming that she is the only one that is able to save Deidre, and so Sky will stop at nothing to bring her sister home, and it's like the story of that. I have never heard anybody on BookTube talk about this, so I have no idea if it's good or not, but like I said, it has been on my TBR forever now. It's been on my Netgalley shelf since the beginning of time. So this is definitely the oldest one on my Netgalley shelf, and I really do need to pick it up. But like I said, this is my kick in the butt to get that shit done. The next two books that I have are part of the same series that again, I've had on my shelf forever. I've actually started the first in the series, and I have the second one on audiobook, so it's pretty much just I have not had time. That's a lie. I have had time, but I've just been focused on other books. So again, this is my kick in the butt to get my Netgalley ratio up, even though it's at 80%, so like, it's not that big of a deal. So the first book that I've actually started already, so we're making progress, is War Girls by Toni Onibuchi. The second book is called Rebel Girls. I have that one as well. This takes place in the future in 2172 in a war-stricken Nigeria. In this world, soldiers are fitted with bionic limbs to help them in their fight. It follows two sisters, Oni and Ifi, and they are dreaming of a better world where this years-long war comes to an end and they can finally live in peace, and so they both join this war to fight for their freedom, and it's like the story of that. And then the second book, Rebel Sisters, is a continuation of this story. Obviously, I have not read the synopsis because I don't want to be potentially spoiled for anything that happens in this book, but I am only on chapter 3, page 25, so, you know, we're still making progress with this. It's just taking a little longer than it's supposed to be because this came out October 2019, so we're very far behind. Then the next book that has been on my Netgalley shelf for 1,000 years and I have a finished copy of now because it's been so long since it's been on my Netgalley shelf is This Is How We Fly by Anna Mariano. This follows a 17-year-old named Ellen who is planning on having an amazing summer with her two best friends before they end up moving away for college. But then she ends up being grounded by her stepmother and all of those plans go out the window. And so she decides that she is going to try to convince her stepmother to allow her to join the local Quidditch team, which is an all-gender, full-contact game that she is not exactly interested in but needs to get out of the house. As the summer goes on, she starts to have a little bit of trouble with her two best friends as they begin to pull away and start to focus on other things. But Ellen has found this new sports team and community to be a part of, and it's like the story of dealing with that. But I do think that this one sounds like the perfect summer read. It just seems like that vibe. So, you know, this is the perfect time to actually read it and get it off that Netgalley shelf. Then the next book that I have a physical copy of is Witches Steeped in Gold by Shannon Smart. And I've already started this. I'm about halfway through now, page 284. And I honestly have no idea what is happening in this book. I am so lost. I honestly don't know if it's because it's just such a complex fantasy world and I wasn't paying attention that much during the reading of this book. I've been listening to it on audio, so that's probably the case, but I'm so lost. All I really know is that it follows two witches who are like sworn enemies and they join together to defeat like the queen of their land. One of the girls so happens to be the daughter of the queen and she wants to overthrow her to become the new queen, but she's not really wanting to be the queen. It's like a rebellion. I don't know. I'm lost, but you know, we're already so far into it that we're going to finish it and hopefully start to understand it soon because I have no idea what's happening. The next one I have, I think sounds so good, so I'm not really sure why I have not picked this up yet, but it is Little Cruelties by Liz Nungit, and Liz Nungit wrote Lying in Wait, which I gave 5 stars when I read it. I thought it was such a good thriller. This is another thriller about three brothers who have spent their entire life competing for their mother's affection and attention, but as they grow older, their tricks and games grow a lot crueler as they go on, and that's when only two brothers survive, and it's like the story of that. So I don't know if like one of the brothers tries to play a trick or something and it goes terribly wrong and ends up killing the other brother and then they have to like work together to cover it. I don't really know. But if it's anything like Lying in Wait, which I loved, then I'm gonna love this one. This one came out either in October or November 2020. It says 11/10/20 and I never know how to read dates like that, so it's either October or November. But been a while on my shelf, so it needs to get done. And then I have a Prison Healer. This is by Lynette Noni, and this one only came out April 2021, so we're getting into the not so bad stage of my Netgalley shelf. This follows 17-year-old Kaiva, who has been working in a death prison as the healer. The Rebel Queen ends up being captured, and Kaiva is given the task to keep her alive until she can participate in the Trial by Ordeal, which is a series of dangerous challenges that feature the four elements: fire, air, water, earth, and is assigned to the most dangerous and deadly criminals. But then a message from her family arrives that simply states, "Don't let her die, we are coming." So Kaiva volunteers herself to participate in the trial in the Queen's place. If she ends up staying alive, then both she and the Queen go free. The only problem is that nobody has ever survived the trial, so it's like the story of Kaiva not really knowing why she is being told to do this by her family, and trying to stay alive long enough for whatever is going to happen to happen. I think this one sounds really good. I think it's going to be really interesting if I ever actually pick it up, because obviously we're taking forever to read these Netgalley books, but it's gonna happen, I promise, eventually. Next one I have is Perfectly Parvin. This one is by Olivia Abate, and this one recently came out in May 2021. This follows 14-year-old Parvin, who was just recently dumped by her boyfriend, and so she decides that she is going to try to get the attention of the hottest boy in school to prove to herself and her ex that she is hot shit, basically. But I'm assuming along the way she's going to learn that, you know, you can be yourself and that is perfect. So yeah, it's like your typical contemporary love yourself kind of book. But like I said, it releases in May. It's May right now, so we really should get it off the shelf just so that we can say we're caught up. And then the last physical book that I have is Baby and Solo by Lizabeth Postuma. This one also releases in May 2021. I'm pretty much done it. I'm listening to it on audiobook. The Netgalley audiobook actually has bits of the book missing, like the end of chapter 11, which is like a huge chapter in this book, because something very important gets revealed that will not make sense if you listen to it and don't have a physical copy. The only reason I know is because I have the physical copy, and it just like abruptly cut off, and I was like, what the heck? Like, that's not the end of the chapter, because I was following along in my physical copy. Besides the point, what is this about? It follows a boy named Joel who has just been released from a mental hospital. His doctor suggests that he should get a job to try to, you know, live a normal teenage life, so he ends up getting a job at a video store. Think Blockbuster, it's pretty much just a Blockbuster. And that's when he meets a girl named Nicole, or better known as Baby, at the store, because they don't use their real names, they all go by movie characters. And they become very good friends. However, Joel is hiding his past and trying very hard not to let Baby know what happened to him, and that kind of has a lot of strain on their relationship, and it's kind of the story of that. Baby's also dealing with some shit, but I'm probably going to end up giving it a 4 out of 5 stars. I'm really liking it. I'm pretty much done. Like, I'm on page 371 of like 406, so I only have like 2 chapters left of it to go, but it's definitely a lot heavier than I thought it was going to be. It covers a lot of very dark topics, like suicide ideation, mental health, you know, that kind of stuff, which I knew it was going to cover mental health, but I didn't know it was going to go that into it. It also takes place in 1996. I was born in 1995, so it's just kind of cool to like have those vibes of my childhood in here, but I'm really enjoying it, like I said. Okay, so those are all the physical copies that I have, and then the one e-arc that I actually have on my phone right now is Trisha Levenseller's Blades of Secret. I'm pretty much done this one as well. I'm like 296 pages or something like that in the e-arc, but the e-arc pages and like the real physical book don't actually line up, because I only have a couple chapters left, so it does not add up, but I'm almost done. It follows a magical bladesmith named Zyva, and she is commissioned by a warlord to produce a magical sword for her, and the sword ends up being very dangerous, and she discovers that the person who asks for the sword to be commissioned is a little bit evil, and so she decides to run away with her younger sister in order to protect the entire world from this sword and this evil warlord. They meet a mercenary on the road, they hire him for protection. They also meet a man named Patrick, who is is like a librarian, and he joins them on their journey because he is trying to write a book about magical artifacts, and so he wants to talk to Zyva and discover more about her magic. Zyva has social anxiety, so she finds being around people very hard, and it's like the story of her on the run with her sister and these two other people coming in, her dealing with her social anxiety. I think I'm probably gonna end up giving it like a 3.5 out of 5 stars. It's very slow at the beginning. It started to pick up now, but I'm kind of disappointed because I was so excited for this book because Trisha Levenseller's The Shadows Between Us was my favorite book last year, and this one is so completely different from that book, and I know that a lot of people did not like that book, but I really did, so I was expecting a lot more from this book, but yeah, it's probably gonna be a 3.5 out of 5 stars, which is not a bad rating, but it's not the 5 out of 5 that I gave The Shadows Between Us. So. And then the last three books that I have on my shelf are all audiobooks. I actually got approved on Netgalley by Macmillan Audio to just pick whatever I want and download it whenever I want so I don't have to wait for approval, which blew my mind and kind of made me go a little bit crazy on what I picked up from them. So, I mean, I only had like probably 60 books on my shelf, and then that happened, and now I've bumped up quite a lot because I think I've listened to like 10 audiobooks in the last like 5 days because I went a little crazy. But the first one that I got was One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston. She wrote Red, White, and Royal Blue. I am so excited to actually listen to this book. I have just heard everybody rave about it, so I just got really excited and hit that request button real fast. That's actually what got me auto-approved because I requested like 3 audiobooks from them at once, and I guess they just didn't want to have to approve me anymore. So yeah, that's the first one that I have. I'm so excited to pick it up because I loved Red, White, and Royal Blue. I'm not gonna lie to you and say I actually know what this is about. All I do know is that it's very gay and that it takes place somewhat in a subway. So I don't know, I am here for it. Then the next audiobook that I got was In a Ravenous Dark by A.M. Strickland. And this one I actually saw during Bookish Bethany's video that I watched, which made me film this video, but it follows a pansexual blood mage, and I just am really excited about that because I don't see a lot of pansexual characters, so it's very exciting to me because I relate. So I just want to read about a pansexual blood mage. I'm not a blood mage because that's terrifying. Bethany also like raved about how good this was. She ended up buying a physical copy because she loved it so much. So I'm hoping that I join that bandwagon and also love it so much. I'm just so excited about this one. But I've been waiting until I finish the Which is Steeped in Gold to pick that one up because that fantasy is just draining me completely because I don't know what the fuck is happening in it, like I said during the video. So, you know, it's taken me a while to get to it, but I am very excited about it. And then the last audiobook and the last book on my Netgalley shelf that I need to complete is Sunkissed by Casey West. This one is actually an e-arc, but my library just got it on audiobook, so I'm going to listen to it on audiobook and follow along with the e-arc, but this one is just your typical contemporary Casey West book. I've read like pretty much all of her books but 2, I think, and I usually give them like a 3, 3.5. I don't think I've ever rated one of her books higher, but I just find her books a very nice like cleansing palette read after you've read like a thriller or a really heavy fantasy book. Just reading a nice fluffy contemporary is sometimes needed, and it's summer, so it's just like the perfect time to read a Casey West book. But yeah, that is the last book on my Netgalley shelf. I think I said there's 14 on there. My goal is to get it down to at least like 8 by the end of June. I am almost done 4 of the Netgalley books, so I think that it's doable. We just have to actually, you know, sit down and do it. But yeah, if you are interested in hearing about what I've rated books that I actually have read so far on Netgalley, then let me know and I'll film that for you. If not, whatever, I will not do that video. But let me know down below if you've read any of these books and what you thought of them, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye!